But when I think about it, bro, man's come so far, fam. I remember man used to do freestyles in that, back in the day. No one really took man seriously, you get me? They just used to watch man freestyle and be like, yeah, you man are hard. But when man said man wanted to do music, they never took man seriously. Man be like, are you sure? Like, not that much people make it, you know? Like, it's not easy. Like, when has anything ever been easy? Like, you get me? Like, we've never stopped doing music. Like, when have you known Crept and Conan to stop doing music? We was doing music from Bluetooth days, Gypset days, freestyles, coming up, grinding. You get me? And now, we've got sold out shows, BET Awards, MOBO Awards, cleaning up every award we're in, MTV brand new, Guinness World Records, highest charting mixtape, for mixtape. It's real, fam. You get me? Like, I go, when I go outside, people ask me for pictures. It's not a joke, fam. It's real. I've got fans crying, saying I'm touching them. Performing across the world, fam. In America, other countries, across Europe. Bro. Like, you think it's been easy for us, fam? Home is success. And we've taken a long way home.
Was your old road,
you see the road right, you see the roadside, that's his road right there. His house is that was my road,
you get me? Like, this is like my road's like the in between from Red Brick.
Yeah,
because his greatest
thing. His one leads behind from my house.
Taking you to where it all kind of started for us. Like growing up, when we first got kind of introduced to like the street kind of world. From being like seven, I felt reason I was in a gang from when I was like seven. TK. So I'm just gonna take you back where we used to congregate and shit. Cause trouble like where first like brewing. Did you get me? Right now driving past my old road where like the My Story situation happened.
Where is it?
Did you get me? So it was this one.
Me and Conan met. Basically it's funny, like one time I must have been in Croydon bus garage, innit? And there was bare men waiting for Conan at the garage, you get me? Like, where's Conan? Like, who's Conan? Are you Conan? You get me? And then man's thinking, rah, you get me? And then I've seen Conan, like, jump off the bus. Because I knew who he was, because he used to spit. And we had mutual friends that went to my school from Fort and Neath, and that, you get me? So I see him, and I was like, yo, look, there's bare men waiting for you at the bus garage.
So I was like, all right, cool. So I just ran and got on the bus and went to my house. And then the next day, I was in school with my friend. Slaps and he was telling me, yeah, bus station something, or some yard man looking for you, you know. One of them was like, yo, that's Conan's brethren, you know. Grabbed him up and tried to throw him in the car and that, but he bust out and ran off and then got away. So yeah, he could have got peaked for me. So yeah, that's how I kind of first encountered with Crep.
Remember, yeah, man used to do sets in there.
Yeah, this is one of the first spots.
That's what got me into skipping.
That's where the confidence started from.
I used to come watch Reds, couple man. And
huge,
then I come watch them man spitting, you get me? I was like, fuck. Mm-hmm. That's why it's mad, this is where I started spitting.
It's literally there, in that church there.
And then I see man going in, you get me? I'm like, fuck, mm-hmm. You just start spitting like these, man.
Yeah.
Fam, this part here, where it all began, you know? Trust me. Little kids running riot, trying out.
First coming up, it was like, we was very, like, very into like, so solid and all that. So that was kind of how we got into the grime thing, or how I got into it, the garage, old school garage and stuff. Like, I remember writing my first lyric when I was like 11, 12. I remember I was in a playground with Trubs. Yeah, and my next two friends, and everyone had their little garage flow, the old school, like heartlessly kind of flow. And I remember I wrote my first lyric and it was like, bubbly, bubbly, something, something. That's how it first went. I remember it started like that. And then I had my second lyric and I was like, hyper, hyper, spit my saliva. Turn into the guy, but da, da, da. I remember that was the first kind of lyrics that I had. And yeah, my name was Kid Rolo back then.
Yeah, Gypset.
We kind of just took influences from that. And when we used to make songs, we used to put it in the songs and talk a lot of crud, like grease. There was no censor on our lyrics. It was just straight whatever's going on. Shoot up this, stab up this, rush this guy, bad boy mode. That's what it really was, innit? So yeah, man, that's what we was doing. Innit?
Musically, like, there was a group, Gypset was like, used to spit me, Conan, Reds, B man, like there was Burnt Weeds for, like, you get me? Obviously them two wasn't like Chipset, but like we used to use their studio, innit? So like we all used to be on the songs together, and like, you get me? That was like our birth of like people in the ends used to play our music, Bluetooth days, you get me? Like chip around, sit around, get around, like if you're from like our part of South, you would have known that them songs there, you get me? I make a boy around Miles, and you get me? That was like, yeah, early Chipset days.
And then there's a stage where we were just running wild on the road, we was on some DVD called South Students. All of us going back to back, skanks, all of us just spitting. You might know him as Ashley Inks now, but yeah. We just going in, everyone was going in, and then everyone just went jail. Like, for a whole period, like all of us were just getting picked off one by one. We just ended up in jail.
Like he wrote to me in jail and he was like, yo, when I come out, we're gonna do this thing, you get me? And I've read it, I'm like, yeah, yeah, when you come out, like, cause I was for, couldn't be awesome. Yeah, everyone's like, obviously you need kind of people to be around you. Like Reds is in jail, everyone's just in jail. I'm like, can't be arsed, man. And then kind of, when he wrote me, I was thinking, yeah, like, man, seriously, we'll get back on it kind of thing. And he come back out.
It's game on, you get me? Man's gonna come out, do a secret mixtape, rah, rah, rah. I remember, like, don't tell no one, I'm gonna come back and do this thing. And then, yeah, man, fast forward and come out of jail.
He's on it, like, he's like, yo, I'm in the studio, I just done some freestyle, like, the freestyle's hard. You get me? I can't remember what the freestyle was called. What was it called again? You come out, you first come out of jail.
Warning shot.
Oh yeah, come out, done a freestyle called Warning Shot.
I done like a grime one and then a rap one. And then that was it, I was just ready to go. Like when I come out of jail, that's when the lyrics just started coming back to me, because in jail I had mind block forever. So when I come out of jail, that's when it all just started pouring back. So I was ready to go.
So you know that obviously you used to come here.
How was it like working here for you, if you don't mind me asking? Did they always give you trouble?
Yeah, sure.
Did they always give you trouble?
Yeah, always.
It just ended up being like more kind of me, Conan and Reds, because we was more active with making songs. Obviously, you would know like Conan had freestyles, like Reds had freestyles, like I had freestyles. Like, you get me? So it kind of shaped and started to be more Crep Conan and Reds. And then we started a mixtape, Red Rum, like, it was me, Conan and Reds, and then Reds went jail, and then me and Conan was like, no, we just need to just bang out, we can just do it, me and you, innit? And then it ended up being Crept and Conan, and that's like how it started. It was like proper by accident, like it was like, that's how you know, like it was fate, you know, them ones that it was meant to do this.
I made a semi-kick, metal grips and a tip, get your melon hit, and when it comes to this music shit, I got more lines than a...
What did you see growing up? How did it affect you up to now?
It was our playground, innit?
It was mad.
That's
mad.
The life that man was living. I would see certain man getting stabbed around the corner and that. It's normal. Certain man getting shot.
Yeah. Get bit by police, dog.
Bun, shot, everything.
Stabbed.
Shot, yeah. Just missed my heart, you get me? Yeah.
It's real over here, do you understand? Like a lot of people know us from back in the day, so if you're from South, you know us, you know everyone's faces, do you understand? It's not even a boastful thing, it's just to say like we've really been out and we're really trying to turn it around, so disrespect it.
Whoa, there's so much money, it's mad. Like your whole Twitter. Your whole Twitter is it.
You've got Sion, you've got Sion,
it's Star Studies.
Back here, go back here. Cos, you've got Star Studies back here, trust me.
You've got, like, the outrage. I'm sorry, it's
you. Yeah, you got Colin. You've got Wes, you've got Anthony Thomas. Are you getting this? Anthony Thomas. Let's start tally.
Spin off the camera, my G. Tiny Box, Cash Tactic, Harry, come on. We're gonna go through.
I'm gonna go through. Okay, I'm gonna shout out to you.
Get me?
Yo,
no one is
here.
Yo, you got Matt, Short, Jem, Ted, come on. It's mad, man.
Make sure they're turned on.
It's mad, it's mad, man.
We're here.
Fucking us. This is a mad feeling. Yes. This is a mad feeling. I don't know how to explain it. It's mad. Like, it's actually happening that we've come from where we've come from to actually be doing our own show. It's mad. It's mad. Spitting on phones and that.
Like even looking at the guests that are coming, I'm fucking so mad.
Fam, look at
like, they're actually coming out for us.
Crept them cold and put me on, and I took that shit for the roof. Ducking round in that drop top, blame that shit on the goose. If I ever lied in a bar, it's probably your girl in the truth.
I first properly heard of Crept them cold, and I was probably like 11 or 12, like first year of secondary school. And they was the guys in the ends. Like everyone knew about them. Even before rap, like I was running around, Gyp Set. You didn't want to see them on the bus back in the day, you get me? But yeah, they've been the guys in there for long, man. And then they was like, back in the day, you know when you used to have songs on your phone? Like they was going around on everyone's phone. I remember there was a Conan one. He says, Gyp Set, Killer Conan, run up, I don't know the, but yeah, there was that one, you get me? There was Correct, I Make a Boy Around Mars, you get me? Like everyone had that on their phone in the ends, you know what I mean? Like they was the guys in the end. So before I even knew them, I knew them.
Yeah.
This is Redwood.
Yeah, this is where the deer's gone. Beer.
This is, imagine.
This is your sort of first man. Head down. Right here. Headman bar, yeah?
When I say fireworks, something like that.
My mum thought it was fireworks. I said, Ma, fireworks don't sound like that. So I came outside in the ice cold and saw bones on the floor with his eyes rolled back.
That's the first time I actually met them, so it wasn't even no, I don't know, just one normal day, and I just literally met them, done the thing quickly, kept it moving. But I think when the engineer sent me the audio the next day, I thought this is actually sick, you know, because when we were filming, I was in a rush, so I never really had time to take it in. And yeah, from when I started listening to it, I was like, yeah, this is too sick. And I started tweeting the lyrics from the thing beforehand, and then a lot of people were like, who's that? Like a Crept them cold, and everyone got a bit excited now. And then when the behind bars dropped, like that's when it just done a madness.
You knew to take it seriously. And we knew like the grease thing was only gonna get you so far. Do you understand? Like the gangster rap thing. So he was like, yo, Miss Tsunami's gonna be the last of the full-on gangster rap. We're gonna kinda just try to talk about more other subjects and kinda relate to everyone and just, you get me, show them other aspects of our life. So we done the Tsunami, and that was like Wretch and Gets and Gigs and everyone, and it was sick. Like it was, I felt like it was a good project at the time. Like the way we just put it together.
I remember I hit up some girl on Facebook, said, "Ra, do a cover of for Tsunami." She's like, "Ah, oh, you need pictures." So me and Conan's gone and done our own little photo shoot with the umbrellas, like in the middle of the sunshine, you know, like on Tsunami, you can see the sun beaming in our eyes, blood. But obviously, these are little schoolboy areas, you get me? Like, Conan's got the umbrella with the... What is it on the umbrella? Is that...
The library.
Huh?
The library of the sun.
No, on the umbrella. What was on... It was like a... it was like an evening standard umbrella, you get me? Like, it was mad.
The way we just put it together and stuff. And like, because we always had issues with studio, so it kind of took longer to come out, because the first engineer would be like, nah, you can come studio, then nah, you can't. And then like he had problems, so we couldn't go studio. And then we met DK, which is, he was young at the time, he was about 16. But yeah, he was a young engineer, had a little studio, and that's where we made the rest of the mixtape.
You see, this alleyway, literally packed. So we're like 20 man, 30 girls, like everyone was like 15 at the time, a mad afro and that. Crep was young. Conan didn't really come around here too tough them times. He used to, but not as much as he would have probably when he got a bit older. A lot of doings have happened in this alleyway though. I don't really want to say what they were, but you know, yeah. You know still.
Yeah.
Yeah. About 80 men would find their arse cheek somewhere on that.
I done a little freestyle here as well one time.
Do you remember rightly?
That little freestyle, obviously.
Yeah, man, we did Tsunami. But like these times we're still kind of doing it as fun, but like we're trying to make a little bit of peas off it now, you know them ones.
These guys were just so consistent with it. I remember it was like 6 years ago that I first bumped heads with Krypton Conan, and they were just dropping things online. And for me, the first record I heard, I knew straight away they had something. But my concern was, could they be consistent with it? And then I watched them for like 6 months. And this is around the time where they was just getting ready to put out the Tsunami mixtape. And I got them up to do a Find the Booth. And I remember meeting them, I was thinking, these guys are good guys. And then having a conversation with them, their heads were screwed on. And then they done the Find the Booth, and I was like, whoa. Their first Find the Booth. There's been certain Find the Booths throughout time, and we've done hundreds of Find the Booths, but there's like a handful where there's been a moment in the studio where you know something's happened, and they're just so rare. And that was one of those moments where I was just like, wow.
Obviously, Krep found out to put on iTunes and it went number two and that. From them days, it was crazy because we thought we bust, like millionaires, number two, are you mad? Not underneath Eminem. Obviously, we didn't know what it meant or sales-wise, because we didn't know how to see the sales before, obviously, the end of the week or whatever. So when it came out number two, it was like, yeah, I was planning on what I was going to buy like a fool. Like, yeah, like, just spending my money. I don't watch that, man. I get that back on iTunes when the iTunes money comes back. When the iTunes money come back, it was zilch.
I remember them putting Tsunami on iTunes. I'll never forget this. And they was like number one in the hip-hop charts. And nowadays, like, all of us are getting number one in the hip-hop charts when we drop our thing, but no one was doing it then. So we was like, rah, like, they've actually got fans, like, people are buying their music, like. And then afterwards, like, when I spoke to them about it, they was like, they didn't even know it was going to actually, like, it just went up, do you get me?
I remember my brethren was like, yo, you know it's on iTunes? And I was like, swear down. He's like, yeah, look, I've got the link. Like, and then I was like, rah, I told Conan, I was like, rah, you know it's on iTunes? Like, because iTunes was mad to us these times, like, man's on iTunes, you know? Like, you type in Krep Conan, and the man's there. Like, man, that was a big deal to us. And then the day it come out, we're out here trapping CDs and that, like just doing the normal mixtape kind of thing. And then man's getting tweets like, you man are number two in the hip hop charts. Like, and man's like, number two in the hip, what? Like, man's gas, like, raw. Like, man was like, man's in the charts. Like, no one was in the charts these times, bro. Like, no one. Like, we was like, nobody was in the charts. Like, man was gas. Like, man was like, bro, man's doing this team. I thought, yeah, we're selling, like, this is mad, you get me? And then off the back of that, like, the streets was just going crazy for that one.
Come on, Reddy, what's going on now?
It's touchdown.
Billions.
100 more. We're gonna go steakhouse.
London living. Yes, we're going to yes. We're going to pattern and cheesecake right now.
What are you buying?
Critters, we've been talking a lot of things. Right now, we're at Michael Jackson's house. Mad.
Are they still taking pictures out of Jesus Christ? This is not a photo shoot.
Legendary. You gotta listen to that. Like, see, when you're listening to man, you gotta listen to the bars. You gotta listen to. Am I patterning? I'm saying.
Pattern.
Yo, I was always in detention. Who thought it would be like this when they gave me my sentence? Got a deal and left the diamonds independent.
See, there's no one in fucking LA. Fish, maybe. And young collard greens.
Cryptoconan, it was through their mixtape Tsunami, and I did some research on them and I asked some people I knew in the music industry in South, and they were like, yeah, you know, they didn't really know. The people were like, they could be really hood, they could be, you know, they could be in trouble. And I usually stay away from trying to involve myself with artists that aren't productive and focused on music and, you know, into other things necessarily. And I didn't know their situation, to be honest, but I thought, let me wait and see what else they're gonna do within the next year or so. And then I just had always heard about them, like people talking their name, you know, even when I talk my little cousins and that in school, they were like, yeah, Crept and Conan.
Yeah? The seven. You see my hood, you go watch my hood, it's the same shop and it looks mad different. They always change owners. You know.
How much is that?
25p, this is 65p, basically a month. Even like some petrol prices, guys.
What's happening? What's happening? Belong here. What's happening?
What's going on?
You tell me what happened. What's good? Holy shit. You know, I lost my crib because of you, though, right? I still remember that girl, me. The little thing from Peckham that came sucking men's dick all night long, remember? Oh, shit! Exactly!
That's old school, exactly. That's old school.
Oh, long times. What's happening, fam? What's good?
Man. Come to see the ends and just show my man around the end.
Yeah?
Old school, bro.
Old school.
Big time. Big time.
I believe I read situations and I can see the bigger picture of things. And I knew just from the jump that Crest and Conan were people that were gonna go. Like, the work ethic, the music they were making, it was destined to be.
When I heard Crept and Conan's mixtape, I was blessed. I was like, finally, they gonna hear what London has to say. Because for so many years, I felt that the whole garage scene and fast-paced chat and rapping was a little bit ludicrous to America's ears. They couldn't understand the lyrics. So when Crept and Conan put out Tell 'Em Don't Waste My Time, it kind of gave America a sense to marinate on the whole music at itself. So I believe that it's gonna be nothing for success. And honestly, if you love hip hop and you love rap and you love urban music, I mean, if you listen to their music and you don't like it, it's only one of two things. You're a hater, or you got hearing problems and you can't hear the melody. Because it's nothing but beauty in that music.
I like it, can't be my baby mama, that's
Hey. It's a ill blow up out here in the US for sure.
Not enough.
Hey, dog.
Coming to the UK, man, all day. That shit hot. Fire.
Bobby. Bobby. Sachi Versace. Oh.
That's raw.
Don't count because I'm 40 plus. So if I like it, then they doing something.
That's just hard. Hell yeah. I like their little applices. And they use like, yeah, ab lips, like I ain't worried about like, they basically, so they flip it, but it sounds harder like this. Yeah, it's dope. I like it.
Fuck yeah, that's just like.
I like it.
Yeah?
I do. UK? Mm-hmm. All right,
London.
Now.
Yeah.
Stop the press. I'm about to get to London and party.
That's exactly what them trap niggas want, bro. It's like this, bro. Show them what it is. My bucks gonna be tough, bro. Yeah, man, I'm gonna have to get that out. They got SoundCloud?
Tight, he's a little retarded. I need to go to London for sure. Tight, the second dude, he killed it. He killed it, that shit was tight as fuck.
What? Waste my time, bitch. Waste my time.
And it's not really what you expect from a London artist. The way the video looks too.
Tight?
Yeah, it looks good. I kind of think it would. I was going to say that.
It's tight.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's tight.
Yeah, I heard.
Yeah.
I seen that.
Yeah, what you say? I like his cadence. I like their flows. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I like it. No, they got skills. They can spit. You know? And they in the streets.
Yeah.
You know, they in the community, you know, and then they also, you know, they're resisting police presence,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
So that's relevant to what's going on here in the United States.
This one, you know what they talking about. Because trap music is, you can have a lot of people speaking real fast and doing all a bunch of craziness, but you don't know what they talking about. I like that because you know it. Don't waste your time. I like that. Hey, yo, shout out to Krypton Conan, man. Hot. Time, bro. Hot mix, bro. Don't waste your time with anything else, bro. They got it. I'm from LA, and I'll tell you, bro, that's trap, bro.
They got the raw look, raw sound to them, and it just lets you know it's hoods all over the world.
Watching their growth as artists and as people as well, for me, was a beautiful thing, because throughout that journey, there's been so many ups and downs, trials and tribulations.
Had to act fast, I can hear them getting closer.
Got a car, we're trying to call up to my gate. But me, I'm very paranoid because I'm from the roads. I just gain that paranoia. So I always have my key in my hand ready. So when I was going through the gate, I noticed there was something in the gate, like a bag of like leaves or some shit. Then I moved the leaves. Like, what's this? And the gate, my gate's like on the ground, so it scrapes in it. So I pushed the gate open and gone. But as I've gone to the door, I can hear footsteps running behind me. Because I'm not gonna take a check, so I didn't stop and turn around to look or to see what it was. I just went in my house, put the key in, boom, opened my door. As I've gone to close the door, obviously the footsteps have gotten closer to me. So they're at the door now. So as I've closed the door, I can see someone's got a gun through the sides, through the corner of the door as I'm closing. So I'm closing it, but they're kicking it, and I'm pushing it, and they're kicking it. And I've actually got it closed, boom. But as I've closed it, they've kicked it, it's come off the hinges. But I'm in slippers, Nike slippers. So I've turned around and I've just darted up the room. My slippers has come off my feet. I'm running up the stairs in my socks. And at the front of my stairs, my room's there, innit? And I was thinking, I'm not dying by myself. Do you understand? That was my whole idea of my mum's room's there, my room's here. And I said, I'm not dying by myself. Like, so if I get shot, no one can call the ambulance if I'm in the room by myself. Do you understand? So that was my whole thought process at the time. I don't know how I was thinking that so quick, but it was just a quick split second thinking, yo, that room. And my mum's room got a lock, so it buys me time, innit? So I ran into my mum's room. My mum's, I ran in there, boom, locked the door, where's the key? My mum jumped up like, well, what's the matter, Carl, what's the matter? I'm like, lock the door, they're trying to get me. I don't know what's going on at this time, so I'm just reacting. My mum's saying, lock the door, so my mum's jumped up. I'm holding the door, I've locked the door, holding the door, boom, the doors, they've kicked the door, boom, they've kicked the door, my mum's jumped up, holding the door with me. My stepdad's holding the door with me, like, what's going on? They're kicking it, it's coming off, I'm thinking, yeah, this is it. I look to the left of me, there's nowhere to run, like, the windows in the house, the window in the room's like this small. I'm like, I'm not getting through that. So I'm holding the door, it's come off the hinges again. Boy, they've shot through the door.
It's hit my mum. My mum's jumped back screaming. Then I've jumped back, like, I'm checking myself, like. But everything's gone slow motion at this time, and I can just see the door keep coming off even more, coming off even more. And I'm just standing there like, fuck, I'm dead, like, I'm gonna die right now. And I'm thinking, I'm only 21, like, I'm dead. Like, what? Like, all of these thoughts is coming in my head at this time, like, I have not done anything. Like, I'm just gonna be another RIP Conan, and everyone just gonna just carry on with their life. This is all that's going through my head. I'm thinking, I haven't even prayed today, like, nothing. Like, I'm fucked. Like, this is it for me. Like, I'm pissed that I have not. Like, the most thing that was bothering me at the time when I was thinking, I have done nothing with my life and I'm just gonna die like this. This is mad. This is what I was thinking. Obviously, this is all slow motion right now to me. I was thinking it's like a mile. I mean, like, all these thoughts is going through my head at the time. My stepdad's run out of there. And then I heard boom, 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 two shots. So I've leaned back against the wall. They've come back upstairs. But I've heard them come back upstairs, and the only reason why I know they've come back upstairs is because my mum's in front of me, like, right in front of me, holding up the mattress, like, don't shoot, please don't kill me. So my mum's screaming this in front of me, and I'm just watching this help. Like, I can't move. Like, if I move, I'm dead. I'm just sitting there, like, I hope nothing's happened to him. I hope nothing's happened to him. And then my mum, I can hear my mum screaming downstairs, like, wake up. Oh my God, screaming his name. And I'm just there, like, I don't know what the fuck's going on. And I've gone in my room. I remember I had, like, went and put on a hoodie, grabbed some trainers, and went to the bottom of the stairs, and I see my stepdad on the floor in the hallway. And my mum's above him, and she's just screaming. Someone's just trying to do art, like, to, you know, when you breathe, what's it, resuscitating, yeah, just trying to resuscitate him. And I just remember stopping at the bottom of the stairs and just looking, and bare commotion. My mum's screaming, he's just there, like just not moving, and the person's on him just trying to resuscitate him. My door's bust wide open off the hinges. I see neighbours outside, and I just stood there for a second, and then I just jumped over him because his legs was at the bottom of the stairs. So I've just jumped over, and my mum's like, where are you going? And I just didn't reply, and I just went outside the house. And then I got in a car, and I was just in a car just in shock. I didn't know what was going on. I just felt so mad, like, this has actually happened. Like, there, and that's Sugar, and that's like, well, what do you want to do? Like, Sugar and Trubs, and that's there. Like, what do you want to do? I'm like, I don't know. We need to get them. I don't know who it is, but we need to get them. We need to get them. That's what I kept saying in the car.
And I've just woken up to Conan message me. Like, he's like, they tried to get me, like, and I was like, what are you talking about? He said, and then I was just, like, I was just mad baffled. Like, I was like, what? Get me, and then, like, I'm trying to phone him, and his phone's not going through. I'm like, what? Then I think it was Shug that told me what happened. And man's just like, you know, when you just think, like, it's mad, like, I can't even explain how man felt.
Yeah, I remember man just thinking, Conan, you're mad paranoid, bro. Like, coming, even like when you come in, like, my phone would ring you, but who's on the phone? So we just thought, he's mad proud, but you remember him saying, yeah, there was a McGann at the end of my road. Never thought nine COVID, you get me? Them not carrying on their session, I think I left. Then I remember the next morning, I woke up, and these Blackberry days, and everyone had, like, Conan on their picture. Like, I'm like, what's going on? And I remember there was some girl I knew on there. I messaged her, like, what happened, innit? Like, what's going on? And this was, like, early in the morning, it was, like, 10 in the morning. Like, I'm like, what happened? What's going on? And she was like, oh, didn't you hear? I'm like, didn't I hear what? Do you know what I mean? And then she was like, oh, something happened to Conan's dad. So I'm like, right, you get me? And I messaged Conan, yo, this has not gone through, you get me? But like, I didn't even really want to message him there, but I just wanted to make sure he was all right, you get me? And then I spoke to Cret, and he told me what happened. I was like, bro, like, I didn't even know what to say.
And then by this time, there's police, there, ambulance, everyone's out of their house. Like, and then they brought my stepdad into the front garden, and my mum's screaming and crying, and the ambulance is trying to save him and stuff, and it's just so crazy. Like, the situation was mad. I remember just thinking, what the fuck? Like, I hope he's not dead. That's what I kept thinking. I hope he's not dead. But if he's dead, it's my fault. Like, and yeah, man, it was just mad. I got my mum coming in, and then they told me, yeah, he's dead, and I just broke down, man. I was like, mom, I'm sorry, like. And she would just hug me, and I was just crying. Like, I was upset, like. I did this to her, do you understand? is my fault. That's what I was thinking. Like, how can I, like, what can I say to her? So then she's hugging me and she's going, be strong, because I can't be strong unless you're strong. Do you get me? And then, yeah, man, that's how that situation went. And then my house was a murder scene for 6 months. I was like, yeah, I'm done with everything. I remember, so I ended up talking to Munch somehow on the phone. And I was like, I'm done with everything. I'm done. Like, I was like, fuck everything, God, everything, I'm done. And then I remember him telling me to read a passage out of the Quran, like, and it was like, whatever God takes away, he takes away, I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was like, he takes away to give you something better. And I feel like that's what kind of made me kind of buck my ideas up and be like man up in it. Trying to stand on, make it break you. I've been waiting.
So I'm just going through each track now then, just getting the settings from the original album and loading the PA exactly. And the cleans. And the piece it back together. Some of the gaps are alright as well, yeah?
Everything was cool, though.
Brilliant. Yeah, it all felt good on the day.
It was good.
Hamish has done a great job. Makes it easier.
I first came across Crept in Conan from the Otis track they put the video up for, and that's when I first noticed those guys. As soon as the video kind of exploded on YouTube with like millions of views and whatnot, I remember kind of thinking, is this real?
It's when they did the Otis freestyle that that's when they really got my attention. They're about to hit a beat that Jay-Z and Kanye West recorded over, and they're going to make that comparison. People were going to say, are these two good enough to even sit on this beat?
They've got that punchline thing which they smash, and I can't think of many people at all in the world, not just the UK, that are on the level in terms of punchlines. But then they've got the more emotional storytelling side to them, where they really do know how to provoke an emotion when they want to do it. And that for me, that's a complete artist, like showing that you've got all these different sides. Even, I remember one point they stepped into the house thing for a minute and they still done it well. Like, there weren't one moment where I thought, you know what, these men are sold out, you know?
But in the morning, I remember I was hungover, my head was pounding, and I got a call from Crep, like, yo, what was on? I remember, like, hello, and he's like, yo, always got a million views. I was like, yo, what? Sober, everything gone, hangover, everything. I was, what's going on, bro? I was like, the first thing I said is, did you snap that? Like, did you take a picture of it? And yes, I said, calm. I remember, like, yeah, you got a picture, yeah? Calm. And I went upstairs and I woke up first. I wake up, bro. And he's like, what? And I was kicking him, like, hey, bro, we got a million views, rah, rah, rah. He's like, yeah, gas mode, you done it, we made it, rah, 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 gas.
And just Skepta hit me, said, yo, I want you, man, to come on tour with me. You get me? And then I told him, like, yo, Skepta wants us on tour, man. Like, oh, my God. Like, this is, everything was just aligning for us, like.
That's why when we done the My Story thing, like, and Crep talking about Skepta, don't know what he did, because that tour, like, really opened our eyes. Do you understand? Like, if you're just doing music in your bedroom or wherever, the studio, and just putting on YouTube and just getting views and fans, like, you won't ever see this real side of music until you start doing tours and shows and stuff. Like, that's where it's really popping. That's where it's really at.
Just like I said, I'm gonna be like,
this is fucking. And there's no choice at all. I meant to be keys on.
But no matter where it is, it's a different fucking crowd, isn't it?
that's not our kind of fan base. So it's always just like wherever we go, it's just like working the crowd and getting, trying to get them to follow our kind of music. So right, and wherever it is, man, you gotta just try and put on a show, bruv. It's tour life ain't easy, so people just think, yeah, going tour, and, yeah, supporting time, yeah.
Slightly, man should have a little one little bathroom in there. The guy in the toilet's all long, fam. No, no. It's a little room and that. Get the hair a little brush, you get me? Gotta go in the public toilet, you get me? It's long. Too used to the star life, you get me? I'm getting too accustomed to it.
We've reached basically the end of the UK leg of the demonstration tour. Yeah, man, I don't even know what to say, man. It's a little bit sad. We've been having so much fun on the road. It's been great. It's been great having Krept and Conan on board, as well as DJ Fresh, as well as Wizkid as well. And yeah, I think, you know, what's next for everyone? I think especially Krept and Conan, I think, you know, their music is definitely sounding great. They just need to make that album now that everybody wants to hear. And yeah, just continue touring, continue showcasing their music. But it was great, man. Their show went down really, really well from city to city. Everybody seemed to be really enjoying it. And all the feedback on Twitter and Instagram about those guys was great. So I have no doubt that they're going to go on to kick.
I'll make you wanna scream my name. I'll make you wanna scream my name, then I'll scream yours when we make love. I'll make you wanna scream my name.
I'll make you wanna scream my name. I'll make you wanna scream my name.
Vash was coming back to us with bad news. That's Cone used to call him, just bad news. Like all the time, just bad news. He just come and said, yeah, nah. The radio said, nah, you need to do this.
So at that time, there was only two DJs playing him on the radio, period. And that was me and DJ Cameo. Both for one extra, no one else was playing them.
Gone to late, what's the label saying, man? Like, what, they're not, nah. They said, yeah, you lot need singers in your group, then they'll probably sign you lot. You know them ones, like, man's thinking, what the, this is mad. Like, said, yeah, you lot, because you lot was funny in Otis, you lot should be like, Ant and Dec. You should be funny. Are you fucking taking a piss? What do you mean, Ant and Dec? Man raps, man. What are you talking about? Man can rap, no one think we can rap no more. Like, you know them ones, man, it's just, everything's just like, oh my god, this music thing's a myth.
But then, yeah, we continued doing our thing. But our songs here and there, Devil's Playground, the song with JME, Boy Better Know I Play Dirty, just experimenting with sound and music, grime and stuff. And we put our song called Numb, experimenting with kind of dancey kind of sound. Mad Video, High Fashion, Furs, Fire Breathers, whatnot. And then, yeah, man, we started working on Young King.
Right now, New York City. Bad Boy Entertainment got an interview with Revolt TV, Play Dirty, Young Kings, UK to the States, my nigga. Come on, Play Dirty, it's a bitch.
A big man. Yeah? You better know what time it is right now. Play Dirty in a bad place.
Honestly, this is all jokes aside. The work ethic thing, like, it's mad, man. Like, I remember when I was doing Young Kings. Bruv, they were sleeping in the studio. Like, man would go there just to, man have to go there to link them. Do you know what I mean? Like, they're not coming to link man in the ends. Man have to go there to link them. The only time they was really linking man after is when they finished it and they started playing some of the stuff. Do you know what I mean? So, man, but they was living there. Even like when I went to go and do Too Young, like, we literally, like, they had been in there from the night before. Do you get me? I swear they had a session the day before that with someone else. And yeah, man, what I've learned the most from Krept and Conan, yeah, bruv, the way they plan things, it's not an accident, bruv.
I feel like before Young Kings was made, there was a real low in, I'm pretty sure, in both of their lives. a real low at that real point of struggle where I think they probably thought we're gonna have to make this music work or we have to leave it alone. And from what I hear in Young Kings, or from what I hear from that mixtape, it's like that struggle made them create something that we can all now hear.
We was working on Young Kings, we disappeared in the summer. Disappeared the whole summer, everyone's turning up somewhere. We was in the studio, we met our producer ADP, and like this was the first time he's even made rap. He didn't even make rap before he met us, you know, he was making that pop record and stuff. First time, first song that, the first rap beat he made was We In Here, because he played it to us and we was like, bro, this beat's hard.
Like, the mixtape originally was meant to be an EP called Quick Time, no, Quick Thing, because we just wanted to make a quick thing and just put a couple of tunes on and just do a quick project just to keep the buzz flowing. And then now we just ended up turning it into a mixtape and took it more seriously. And I remember what Young Kings, I remember listening to Meek Mill's songs like, Young Kings, Young Kings. And I was like, yeah, Young Kings. Like, let's call it that, Young Kings. And I was like, yeah, that's where kind of the name came from.
Radio's still not rating, man. Like, when we put out My Story's like, and then the world kind of knows what happened. You feel me? Like now everyone knows, like, oh, like maybe it was a bit too hard on them, a bit. Do you know what I mean? But like, radio still wasn't really playing, man. And you get me, man, was just like, whatever, man. We never done this for radio anyway. It was just like, if we got on radio, it was a bonus, and it was like, whatever. It was for the fans, for the people, so they know what's going on. Put out My Story, that's what. Got in the papers, like it was, you know what I mean? It was going mad virally, it was going mad bare views, and you get me? And then we dropped Don't Waste My Time.
Tell them don't waste my time, waste man waffling down my phone. Tell them don't waste my time.
But still, radio and the media weren't really getting behind it, they didn't really know what to do with it. And then the mixtape dropped. And the sales were so ridiculous. I think in the midweek, they were at number 8 in the album charts, in the national album charts. This is not hip-hop charts normal. This wasn't territory for people to be like, oh yeah, it's rap music, write it off or ignore it. They were doing better than most pop acts. And every record label in this country pays attention to the top 10 album charts, because all of their acts are constantly in there.
Because I remember Conan had the bar. You remember saying it like, excuse my French. I remember he said it to me in there, and I was like, I need a little line, you know. I was thinking, I need a little line as well. That's what I was thinking. Yeah, I just made the Rihanna one in my head, you get me? And I was like, yeah, I'm going to save that for tomorrow. Come studio, bang it out. And then, like, yeah, like, I was like, yeah, this is a banger.
I was there when Crep Lady's verse, you get me, to Don't Waste My Time. But what it was is, I remember he dropped me home, yeah? And we're listening back to it in the car, and he's banging it. And like, remember, I know the man that go in. Like, I'm gonna be dead real. Like, when I heard Crep say about, I need that drama unless she real, I was thinking, come on, Crep, bro. Like, you could have said something better there.
He was reacting to every song, like that one, he was just like, because he knows that man goes in, you know them ones, he goes in as well, so he would know, like, that would stand out to him, like, fam, you man ain't going in, you know, kind of thing, like, you get me? But like, I was explaining to him, like, this is bigger than what we, like, what we're trying to do. You know, the ones is bigger than going in. Like, you get me, trust me, like, they're going to be spitting this line, man. Trust me.
And he was going, fam, they've got to sing it, fam. They've got to sing it. I'm like, yeah, I hear all that, fam. But you could have said something better there. Like, them times there, me, myself, obviously, these lot was obviously not thinking about that. I'm just thinking about going in, fam. I just want to have the best punchline, the best verse, you know what I mean? Man, they shut me up.
Like, flew into the charts midweek. We're at number, the top 10 in the midweek charts, like independently. No label, no radio, no TV, like no help, like man's top 10, you know. So everyone woke up, like everyone that was sleeping on us, everyone was like, all right, cool, like these men are onto something, like we slept on them, like, you know them ones, like, you know how good it felt, like, to be like, told you lot, bro. You know, it wasn't real, you thought that was fake. You're gonna say this is fake. You're gonna say these sales are fake.
He phoned me like on my birthday, like, yo, we're nominated. And I remember they just brought over my steak, you know, and it looked so nice. But I was so excited, I couldn't eat. Like, I tried to eat, I took one bite, and I was like, we're nominated for a Mambo, you know? I kept saying it, and everyone in the restaurant was just looking at me. I was sitting next to Van Persie in the restaurant, I remember, and he's just looking at me, and I was like, nominated for a Mambo, is my mad? I was on a hype, but I was the only black guy in there. Because it was a very posh restaurant. I was like, nominated for a mob, but they mad. And I was just making that bare noise. And the girl that was with me, like, calm down, calm down. They're looking at us. I was like, fuck that, you dumb. Mob potion, eh? I was on a hype. I was like, fuck this, come here, bounce. Paid the bill and just breezed out.
And the Marvel Best Hip Hop goes to
Crepton Conan.
Crepton Conan!
Crept and Conan, best newcomer!
Since their first mixtape in 2010, the South London duo have made a bigger impact on the underground scene than the Piccadilly line.
Yeah! Mobos, yeah!
Last year, we got nominated for best newcomer.
I want to big up all my fans, Team Play Dirty, everyone that voted for us.
And all the supporters, thank God, my beautiful mum, all my brothers here with me.
Make some noise for Conan's mum right now, people.
Yeah, man.
I just want to say that Conan's mum, her strength has inspired me as a person because she's lost her husband and Conan got him living through music. So rest in peace, Carlton, as well.
Yeah, this one's for you, man.
Best hip hop, man. Mama, I love you.
Play Dirty Young Kings, man. For any if you already know. Shout out my brother Bounce. I know you're watching, man. Miles, we're there.
You just got to learn from every single experience and build from it. So I feel like that's what we're good at doing. So yeah, we just kind of, and at the end, it was just easy, man. I remember it just being easy. Like, well, are we ready here, guys? Like, sound check, we just be fucking about, like, making up lyrics and sound check and fucking about, because we was confident now. We knew what we was doing. And yeah, man, it was just a turn up in the end, man. And I feel like we gave him some fans. And yeah, man, it was good. Good luck. Big up Tiny for that, man. And Tommy, man, sick.
Yeah, this is sort of happening, and what the guys are doing, I kind of have high hopes that it will be the thing that finally will bridge the gap between here and the US. You know what I mean?
Is this song you play all the time?
Like Will Smith or something? What's that group from London?
Tiny Temper?
What's they called? Crep and Conan at Don't Waste My Time.
Oh, get out of here. Yeah, I
if
know that song.
If she ain't fucking, she got to go.
What?
Tell her don't waste my time. Yo, that's Boo Will's jam.
Will is ill, so all right, let's get into that too, man.
I'm just speaking to him, man. General ones, and then through that, he said, well, come to my, after my performance, come to our dressing room. And we would talk and smoke and chill.
You got my number, so you got to come on. Appreciate you guys, man. I appreciate you guys. Hell yeah, you got to do the album.
What up? You already know it's your boy Jeremiah out here, UK. Road Dogs, Crap the Conan, Freak of the Week on the way. That's me in the background right now, a lot of beautiful ladies out there. We basically met, what was it, about last year sometime. And through a friend, and I came out here, and crazily, I was at the Mobile Awards where I actually got a chance to really see exactly what was going on out here in UK, which I really didn't know much about, but they definitely hopped on my last single featuring YG, Don't Tell Them, and Body They Versus, so I wanted to see if they could come out with me on Mobile Awards, and sure enough, we closed it out, and it was definitely one of my most memorable life experiences, and and since then we've been turning up. I played them this record featuring it wasn't featuring nobody at the time, it was produced by DJ Mustard. And I had this beat for the longest, it's the craziest thing, and I actually played for Crep.
Yeah.
And and he was fucking with it. He was like, yo, send me that joint. And from then on, they sent me back just some references. I sent them some references, and the outcome is here we are, which is the reason why we're here today.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, man.
Man, I ain't gonna lie, they're probably one of the hottest people out here in the UK. I feel privileged to do a record with them. And I can't wait till everybody actually get a chance to hear this record. I feel like it's real special. It's like a little form. You call it, I'll call it the hoagie sauce, but from Don't Tell Them, just knowing off what happened with that and just similarity with, you know, when people hear records that they're most familiar with. I just think from the Mustard Beat to just the old, what is it, Sean, who is that, Sean Paul?
Yeah, Sean Paul, Beanie Man.
Beanie Man sample. And we flipped it completely, and man, it's smacking. It's for all the ladies, all the freaks out there.
Come on.
We can't wait to meet all y'all.
About, I met them up in like the summertime, July at the Wireless Festival. You feel me, they went on before me. And when they went on stage, shit was crazy. It was turned up. So I'm asking everybody, I'm like, why y'all put me on after them? Because they shit was popping. I'm like, why y'all do that? But when I went on stage, man, was fucking with me too. I didn't know they was gonna fuck with me like that though. But I met them at the Wireless Festival. You see me, we chopped it up.
He was like, yeah. And then he was like, yo, we need to make something happen. Like, you know them ones. And then like, why'd you, like, he did his research.
And then I came back to the States, you feel me? Doing my homework and shit. Everybody in London fuck with them, you feel me? That's what everybody say, you feel me? They the niggas out here, you feel me, on the rap shit. You feel me, they running the shit out here. And then, they hit me to hop on the record for like album.
And then we sent him the song, he was like, yeah, this is hard. He sent us over his verse.
So I hopped on that shit, came back out here on my little tour. I had my first show in London, and I hit them, and they was in town, and they came out. You feel me? That's how I happen, regular shit. You feel me? When you fuck with niggas, you fuck with them. You feel me? You hit them up, they're around, they supporting. Then we got the video shoot today.
And the Rick Ross one was mad. Like, you see when you speak things into existence. Conan always used to say it to me, like, trust me, don't say that. You're speaking it into the world. Take it back. I'm like, what are you talking about, man? And then, like, you kind of, it's mad. Like, you speak things into the world, bro. Like, so you want something to happen. Say it, bro, it will happen. You know what I mean? So, like, I remember, like, we was like, Cohen's like, nah, we need to get Ross, fam. Like, trust me, fam. We need to get him somehow. Like, man don't have the slightest clue how man's getting this man on a song. You get me? Like, we've done a song with Rick Ross in mind. You get me? We've done a song, like, with him. Like we're going to get Rick Ross on this kind of song. We're going to get him on the song. We just said, no, this is gonna happen.
I had a fortunate experience to see you working in the studio. Worked with Krebs and Conan. Never thought I'd see that happening. What's your take on that music?
Oh, it's most definitely powerful. It may be, you know, some of the best street music that I heard, you know, that's coming from on this side, the English side, real talk. My DJ pulled a beat up 5 minutes before we left. And, you know, I pretty much wrote the majority of the verse in the car ride over.
There was a lot of references to the UK. You said a lot of things that I was like,
right.
Whoa.
The thing that I'm most proud of and excited about for them is what they've achieved in terms of the sorts of collaborations that is on the album, you know, from, you know, Ed Sheeran, Emily Sandé, Rick Ross, YG, Jeremiah. I've never seen anything like it before. It's actually quite astounding from that point of view. So I'm just excited that they've been able to achieve that, and I'm excited to be a part of those things, because I think that culturally, in terms of like British music period, I've never seen anything like this before.
Yeah. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way so I can hear the beat play. Yeah, yeah. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way just to hear the beat play. Yeah. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way home. I'ma take the long way, long way.
it's crazy to think that everything we've done is to get to this moment here. Like, all the struggling, all the hardship, the late nights in the studio, losing family members. Like, to get this one shot, this one chance, the album, The Long Way Home, it all could change for us. And it's only just the beginning.